All right. We'll see how this turns out. I was watching 5150 MXVW Jason's video a little bit ago on him saving another VW. And I left a note about how quite a few years back my son saw an old beetle sitting in a farm field all by itself, and the only trees in his farm field, wouldn't you know it, fell down on top of an old beetle. And he would drive by and see it, you know, on his way home from school, and it just kept bothering him, saying, "Man, Dad, we got to save this thing. It's just so sad to see it there." Well, he convinced our friend of ours, who helps us with getting beetles, to help him out. And here's some photos they took back in when they did this. We didn't have the video camera, or we're doing YouTube. So you can see, you know, how sunk in it is in the ground. And then there's the tree, and yeah, it's a ragtop. And a tree laying on top of the hood. It didn't have a motor. The engine lid was in back of the car, so that was a good salvageable part. Again, look at the tree. It really had done a number on the beetle. Let's see if I can zoom in. So you can see it really did a number. Yeah, this is taking too long. Let me show some other photos. So there's another angle. And there you can really see how much damage was done. The driver's side door and driver's side was pretty much destroyed. It's, I don't know how long it's been. Well, the tags on it said 1972, so it had been sunk and pounded in the ground for quite a while. There's a front view. And he's like, "We gotta save this. We gotta save this." Look at that. The hood suffered some damage, but you could straighten it out. You can see some waves and bumps in the hood in this area here. Trim piece looked good. Again, it's amazing he spotted it from the road. And there's the driver's side. And you can see the road back here that he would drive by and see it. And the farmer agreed, you know, "You want to go in and get it out of there? It's all yours, buddy." There is no title. Again, more angles. There's a shot of the inside. There's the engine lid in the back. Had a driver's seat, didn't, the passenger seat couldn't, it was gone. And the birds were watching, saying, "Man, are these guys crazy?" So you can see the tree's gone. Roger, our friend, had his chainsaw and already started cutting the tree away. You can see all the sawdust. And this is the driver's side door where the tree really was laying. Yeah, a few pine cones. And you can see the back wheels. I don't know if it's a roller or not. So there's a friend, Roger, who was taking a break after cutting a tree off the car. So now it's like, okay, how do we get her out of here? And again, you can see how badly damaged the hood is and the ragtop. Well, he has a dually, so he chained up to it and dragged it out. But then it's how do you get it on the trailer? So he had to go back home and get a skid loader with the forks, and he actually lifted the car up and put it on his trailer. Also, when he had the forks, he put the forks inside the driver's side and lifted it up, and it kind of straightened up the hood a little bit. It was like, oh, maybe we can save it. So there it is. As you can see, this was all smashed down. He put the forks in here, lifted it up, really kind of straightened it. But, yeah, that window frame looks a bit toast, and I don't think we could straighten the door out. Don't think we could save the fender. But believe it or not, to my surprise, you know, I thought, oh, I felt so bad you're wasting Roger's Saturday digging this out. And it turned out there were a lot of good usable parts. And in the end, they had a blast. They had fun doing it. They really had a great time. They got pictures, and now it's the big memory or story of remember the beetle we saved in the woods. So, Jason, yeah, my son likes going retrieving old VW metal also. So, we don't have as many in Iowa as you have in your neck of the woods, but he somehow can find them. And so there it is, buddy. Keep finding the VWs, and that will maybe, it always makes for a good video, good memories. And it's amazing how you can find good parts. You know, there was some folks that needed parts. This was a 1959 ragtop. So there we have it. I figured I'd do a short little. I know I told the story and said I'd do a little video explaining it. So there it is, buddy. We'll talk to you later. Bye.